Hey everyone, this is Zach with AD20 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a failing alternator. An alternator in a vehicle is a type of electric generator. While the engine is running, it is responsible for charging the battery as well as powering any electronics and any accessories while the vehicle is running. So the alternator is belt driven, and ultimately it's the drive belt or the serpentine belt spinning that is then able to power the alternator, which again then in turn charges the battery and powers all of these electrical systems within a vehicle. When it comes to symptoms of alternator problems, an alternator and a faulty or old battery do share many of the same signs and symptoms of failures and problems. There are a couple ways to identify which is the ultimate issue that you have on hand, whether that be the battery or the alternator. And we'll circle back to that at the end of the video, but for now, let's go ahead and jump right into some of the most common signs and symptoms of a failing alternator. At number one, again, this shows how much the battery and the alternator tie together and how it can sometimes be a little confusing to know which is the ultimate problem. Number one on the list here, we have a dead battery. The alternator, while the vehicle is running, is responsible for recharging the battery. And so if you do have alternator problems while you are driving the vehicle, it may not be generating enough voltage and enough power to actually recharge the battery, which can in turn lead to a dead battery. And so obviously that can be a little confusing there. If you have a dead battery, it's easy to jump to the immediate conclusion that it's the battery that's faulty, especially since batteries are common maintenance and replacement items. But ultimately, a dead battery can indeed just be a symptom of an alternator issue. Moving into number two, another common sign and symptom of a failing alternator are dim or flickering lights. So as the alternator begins failing, it can provide inconsistent voltage to all of the electronics and all of the accessories in the vehicle. As that voltage drops and rises and just inconsistent voltage, that's when you can start noticing those flickering lights. And it can be a couple different lights. That may just be any interior lights, your dashboard lights, headlights, really any lights within the vehicle. If you're getting that inconsistent voltage from the alternator, you might notice those flickering lights, or if you're just getting a low voltage output in general, that's when you can start seeing some of those lights becoming a little bit dimmer. So if you do notice dimmer flickering lights, certainly one of the most common signs and symptoms of a faulty alternator. Moving on to symptom number three, we have slow or problematic accessories. And this ties a little bit into dim or flickering lights. So just like we were talking about with the inconsistent voltage or possibly low voltage, you can notice issues with really any other electrical systems within the vehicle. So this might be that your radio isn't working, or if you have a car that uses an amplifier or an amp for the sound system, maybe the sound system sounds weird because the amp isn't getting enough voltage to run properly. Your power windows may roll up and down more slowly than they usually do, or they may roll up a little inconsistently. They might speed up for a second, then slow down. That could be, again, that inconsistent voltage coming from the alternator. So really any form of dim or flickering lights or any other troubles or issues with other electronics and electrical systems within the vehicle can all point back to potential issues with the alternator. Moving on to number four, another common symptom of alternator problems are whining or grinding noises. One thing that's important to note up front here, there are a lot of different engine components and a lot of different vehicle components that can lead to similar whining and grinding sounds. So if that's really the only symptom you're noticing, it might not be the alternator. You could certainly have something else going wrong with the engine. Another thing to mention as well is the alternator, again, is belt driven. When a belt starts going bad, those can often create similar whining sounds. And of course, as that belt goes bad, if it stretches or snaps, that can also cause issues with the alternator, since the alternator is driven by that drive belt, also known as a serpentine belt. So that's another problem that can create similar sounds and symptoms. So certainly something to be on the lookout for if you are experiencing alternator problems. It could be the drive belt or serpentine belt, especially if you're having issues with other accessories powered by those belts, such as the power steering system or the water pump on some vehicles and a couple other ancillary components of the engine. Ultimately, if you're hearing any whining or grinding sounds, double check if it's coming from the area of the alternator and you have some of the other common symptoms of alternator failure, then that could certainly be another sign that it really is the alternator that is on its way out. Moving on to symptom number five of alternator failure, we have burning wires or burning rubber smells. If you've ever smelled an electrical fire, that's kind of a similar smell that you'll notice from the alternator as it starts going bad. What this boils down to is the alternator can start overheating and getting a little bit too hot when it is failing and on its way out. That's when you'll start smelling some burning smells potentially. If the alternator again is overheating or getting too hot, it can start burning some of the internal components of the alternator, and you'll notice that electrical fire smell coming from the alternator. So again, just something to be on the lookout for if you suspect you have alternator problems and that's accompanied by a burning smell, then that's probably a surefire sign that you do indeed have some issues with your alternator. Moving into symptom number 6 and the last on our list here, another common sign and symptom of alternator failure is the engine actually stalling. So again, the alternator is responsible for powering electrical systems and providing voltage to the vehicle while the engine is running. One key component of that is the alternator, which is then responsible for sending the necessary voltage to the ignition coil, which in turn sends that to the spark plug to create the spark and actually start the combustion process in your engine and within the cylinders. So if you don't have enough voltage going to those ignition coils, they won't be able to spark the spark plug, which means you can't ignite your air fuel mix. And ultimately, if you don't have any combustion, the engine cannot run, and that will lead to engine stalling. One thing to note here is if you are running into engine stalling with alternator problems, that's likely a surefire sign that the alternator is on its very last leg. Ultimate failure is likely imminent at this point. The reason for that is most modern cars, especially anything 2000 plus, especially 2010 plus, is typically designed to have the alternator and any voltage go to certain components and certain electrical systems before others. For example, if the alternator is providing limited voltage, it will try to send that to the ignition coils rather than prioritizing things like the sound system, the radio, power windows, etc. Since again, ignition is important and a key component of your engine actually running and not stalling out. So that's part of the reason why if you are running into engine stalling with an alternator problem, that's likely a sign that it's on its very last leg. That sums up the most common symptoms and signs of alternator failure. Now, towards the start of the video, I had mentioned that the battery and alternator both show similar signs and symptoms when they're failing. And so there are a couple key differences and a couple ways to tell whether you have a battery problem or an alternator problem. One major difference is when you have a battery failure and the battery is on its way out, just getting old, tired, worn down, a battery will typically not hold a charge. So if you try charging the battery overnight or try charging it for a couple hours and then let it sit overnight or let it sit for 24 hours, if the battery has lost a bunch of voltage in that time frame without you having driven the vehicle, then you probably have a battery problem on your hands. Now, on the other hand, if you charge the battery, it holds all of that voltage overnight or for the next 24 hours, and then you go take the car out for a drive, suddenly you come back home, plug the battery charger in again, or check the voltage with any other tools or equipment, and you notice that the voltage on the battery has suddenly declined a lot, that's probably a sign that your alternator is the actual issue at hand, because again, the alternator is responsible for recharging the battery and supplying energy and voltage to all of these electrical systems. So if the alternator isn't functioning properly, that puts a little more strain on the battery to get the job done, and so that can ultimately cause the battery to lose voltage in a short time, especially after driving the vehicle. So little difference there, and something that you can use to tell whether you have an alternator or a battery problem. Now, another way to tell, and this ties into a little bit of what we discussed with the engine stalling, if you jump start your engine and everything runs fine, you don't have any symptoms or issues after that, then you probably have a battery problem. On the other hand, if you jump start the engine and it stalls out shortly after, or you still have dim or flickering lights or issues with other electronics and accessories, then you probably have an alternator problem, because that's responsible for actually supplying the voltage to all of that while the engine is running. So again, another big difference there that can help you determine whether you have a battery or an alternator problem. So it does take a little diagnostics, but ultimately it's pretty simple stuff that just about anyone can do at home, even without any tools and equipment, just trying that jump starting method. Or again, if you have a battery charger or anything that can read the voltage on a battery, those are simple ways to tell whether or not you have a alternator failure or an issue with the battery itself. Anyway, that wraps up our video for today, guys. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.